Whether you may become an addict could be in your genes. That's the idea behind a new Southern California medical test that hopes to curb the opioid epidemic. Andrea Fujii has a story you'll see only on Two.
Who's your baby mommy?
Sue Henriquez is her mom's caregiver.
She's my baby.
The 62-year-old suffers from chronic pain and has been on high doses of prescription painkillers like oxycodone for years.
Addicted, and she needs it. Without any pain medication, the woman would be literally on the floor.
Sue says she too lives with debilitating pain from migraines and a back injury, but she's worried she'll become an opioid addict just like her mom.
Sometimes I have had chronic pain and won't take medication just because I fear going down that path.
Sue, how are you?
Sue's doctor, Marina Del Rey surgeon Human Melamed, says he often sees patients who are overprescribed opioids.
And if you and I were to take one of the amount that they're on per day, I mean, you and I would literally die.
So Dr. Melamed and about 300 other doctors around the country now offer PROVE, a genetic test that promises to determine a patient's risk for addiction.
You could be upping all these medications, but their genetic profile may not be allowing them to respond to this medication appropriately.
Sue jumped at the chance to take the PROVE test.
The test is relatively simple. The patient fills out a questionnaire and is swabbed for DNA, and within a couple of weeks, they have the results.
This is cell phone video of Sue getting swabbed, and days later, her results.
You're at moderate risk for opiates, actually.
But the test also showed she has low pain tolerance.
You're going to need more, and you're already at high risk to begin with, so which means you can go down the wrong pathway very quickly.
She also learned what medications won't work, some that she's already been prescribed.
The largest and most expensive health condition is pain.
PROVE creator and CEO Brian Meshkin says to curb the opioid epidemic, patients must know what drugs will work and their probability of becoming an addict.
We can imagine a day where a doctor will prescribe a medication, actually knowing whether a patient's going to respond or not, rather than just guessing.
PROVE is based in Irvine, and the one-of-a-kind test has been out for a year. Meshkin says its accuracy so far is about 90%. Based on Sue's results, she and Dr. Melamed will design her best course of treatment. But now, armed with this information, she says she's hopeful she won't have the same fate as her mother.
This is so important to me. I mean, this is the meaning of the rest of my life.
In Marina Del Rey, Andrea Fujii, CBS 2 News.